In this video, I am going to explain biomechanics of movement of hip, pelvis, and lumbar spines. I usually focus on this complex a lot. Why? Because when somebody flexes leg, it's like this movement, hip flexion, your hip doesn't move by itself. What do I mean? When you do hip flexion, your pelvis should move like this. This is exaggeration. Hip flexion, then your pelvis should move this way. Then there are lumbar spines. Then lumbar spines should move like this. Okay, like this movement, this one continuous movement. Hip flexion, pelvic go this way, then lumbar should elongate it. Vice versa, when you do hip extension, pelvis should move this way and lumbar should move like this way, okay? This movement. Hip, pelvis, lumbar spines. Hip, pelvis, lumbar spines. So you should not ignore this continuation. That is why I focus on this complex. Now let's see on real person. Hip flexion, his pelvis should move this way as well. Hip movement, pelvis moves and lumbar should move like this, like this. He is very flexible. However, I feel tightness here. This is on anterior part of hip. There are many muscles that affect hip movement because literally many muscles cross hip joint. So each muscle has chance to inhibit hip movement. Maybe gluteus medius inhibits movement. Maybe gluteus maximus, tensor fasciae latae, iliacus, rectus femoris. Many muscles are kind of intertwining each other. So the tight place varies, depends on people, of course. This person is tight on lateral part. Good. Let's see. Again, hip, pelvis, and lumbar should move simultaneously as one flow. Hip flexion. Nice movement. You see that? His hip, pelvis, and lumbar are moving as one unit, one continuation. So again, I do not ignore hip, pelvis, and lumbar relationship. Very important complex. If you liked today's video, please hit the like button, comment, and subscribe. See you next video.